In this success series, I've been talking about the various tips that I believe will help you in your journey to success. I'm now going to the next half. I've done the first five, and you can refer to them in the channel. I'm going to the success tip number six. Now, how we respond to our emotions can either help or hinder the pursuit of our goals and our overall success and happiness. The ability to harness your emotions is a key determinant of success. My name is Catherine Gaho, and I'm in the business of research and training. Research shows that emotional mastery is key to being able to get rid of distractions and to stay focused on your goals. These days, we use emoji to express emotions in our text messages. This is an attempt to show our feelings and emotions that are difficult to capture in text. Emotions are brief and intense feelings that well up inside us based on our moods, relationships, happenings, or circumstances. They are our responses to the internal and external events. Different people respond differently to the same situation based on their perception and interpretation of the situation. Emotions always shift us to one direction or another. They are never neutral. When they are positive, they bring good feelings of pressure. When they are negative, they bring bad feelings of pain. When negative emotions dominate your mind, they can escort you into a negative territory. You know, they take you to negative places that can cause you to act in ways that are not in your best interest. The other day, I saw an interesting clip going around about anger management on WhatsApp. It's about anger management. And it says, if you're angry with someone, think before you talk. If the person is junior to you, count up to 10 and then talk. If the person is equal to you, count up to 30 and then talk. If a person is your senior, you then count 50, then talk. And if the person is your wife, keep counting and don't talk. And if the person is your husband, keep talking and don't count. I don't know what that means, but basically, it's to tell you how many people look for ways to explain how emotions work. And what this person is trying to do is to look at how do we manage our anger so that it serves our best interest. And that's why I believe that having mastery over emotions, you know, being able to harness your emotions is very key to success. Emotions can make you act in ways that cause you to regret. Either way, emotions influence our thoughts, which influences our decisions, which influence our actions, which cause various outcomes, and which impact on our success. The great mastery of our emotions is linked to emotional intelligence, which is the ability to interpret different emotions effectively and to apply that to improve our thoughts and actions. Emotional intelligence is associated with self-awareness, self-management, motivation, and social skills. And these have a lot to do with achieving your goals. A simple definition of success is to achieve what you want. Emotions play an important role in achieving what you want and in enjoying what you get or being happy and fulfilled with your achievements. Happiness is an emotion of pressure, while sadness is an emotion of pain. No matter what success means to you, whether it's having happy relationships, a satisfying job, a great business, more money, peace of mind, spiritual connection, greater health, or even a better home, your awareness and ability to harness your emotions will contribute to that success. We all tend to agree that mastering our emotions is not always easy. So let's consider this question. To what extent do you think that the level of your emotional mastery has contributed to your success or failure in your career, life, or business? Would you say to a limited extent, or to a moderate extent, or to a high extent? The point is, the way we are able to understand and manage the emotional triggers that influence our actions in an effective way, the more we will be able to accomplish what we desire. But how can we be able to shift our emotional states and remain focused on our goals? Let me propose four steps that will help in shifting your emotional state. One, pause and reflect. Once something happens and you feel negative emotion rising, such as anger or frustration wearing up, you need to pause and reflect on where that is coming from and what it means. Reflect on how you are reacting to that situation. Awareness or acknowledgement is key to control where emotions are concerned. Think about this. Someone hits your car from behind. You feel your innocent, your self-righteous self feels angry and you want to react. But before you come out shouting and kicking, you pause and reflect. And that will take you to think about the meaning of the situation and the best way to deal with it. So an accident has occurred. Think, reflect on who is hurt. What is the damage? What can we do about it? And so on. That is going to shift your mindset to a different direction. As you shift to thinking about assessment or evaluation and questioning, your emotional state will start to change. Your feelings can no longer overwhelm you after you've shifted to a more rational outlook. I once did research for a company where the staff told me about the emotional outbursts of their transport manager. When given information that an accident had occurred, they felt that he cared more about the goods being transported and the vehicle than the people who were in the vehicle. What is their well-being? He does not inquire about that. So you can tell that this is a person who does not pause and reflect and who has low emotional intelligence. Because in reality, if you have a vehicle moving goods, it's also being driven by people, it's being managed by people. How would you possibly focus more on the equipment? Two, change your perception. Perception is the way we see the world around us, the way we interpret the happenings and occurrences in our lives. Upon reflection, you need to reevaluate how you are feeling and you change the interpretation. In the case of that car accident, you might start by appreciating that no one was hurt. And that might shift your perception of the situation and change your emotion from anger to gratefulness. Third, clarify what you want. Determine what outcome you want out of the situation. Whatever situation, what do you want out of it? This is a point where you might start to remember that in the case of a car accident, there is insurance, there is this and that, and there are possibilities. You can even negotiate and agree if the matter is not so big. In some cases, it's more important to save the time and run to the meeting you are going to attend than to stand there and start arguing, because the damage maybe is too little and you can take care of it. And the cost of taking care of it is lower than the loss you will have if you spend too much time and miss that important meeting. Number four, take appropriate action. Take the first step towards what you want. Go to the direction of your interest, the direction of the greatest benefits to you or to society or to the people involved in the situation. If you are feeling lonely, act to link up with someone that you enjoy talking to. Call someone who makes you laugh. Call someone who you feel by just having a discussion, it will lift you up. Even a small action will help you shift your emotional state and help build the resilience you need to accomplish your goals. The idea is to move. Take action means you start moving in some way or the other, and that will shift your feelings. To sum up, the four ways to harness emotions and remain focused on your goals are: one, pause and reflect. Two, change your perception. Three, clarify what you want. And four, take appropriate action. Thank you for watching. If you're new here, remember to subscribe and comment. Thank you and best wishes. We all need to elevate our mindset at this time.